and not when things are stable. Discussing. Okay? Discussing in terms of? Okay, yes. But on the flip side, very often you find people enjoying haranguing about their health. A lot of times people who have chronic illnesses enjoy discussing the fact that they are ill. Right? Probably at some level they've not consciously chosen their attitude, but the attitude has become one of complaining. So what we need to start with before we go on to the next levels is to really define for ourselves, do we indeed have an attitude for health? And if yes, what is it that shapes that attitude? What is our health identity? How many of us enjoy being, and strangely enough, a lot of us do, enjoy being a victim of health? Come to think of it, a lot of us, because our health gives us something to discuss, gives us the attention and love of family members, choose unconsciously to be unhealthy, because that's one way of gaining attention, and that becomes a part of our identity. Look back into our families and think about it. So many of us with arthritis or joint problems or migraines, severe headaches, or even children who keep repeatedly falling ill, obviously there is a subconscious pattern which tells them that when I get unhealthy, I get all the attention. I get all the love from my parents. I get all the attention from my grandparents, whoever else. Yeah? You get pampered. And that's the ego stroke that you get. And because of which, very unconsciously, you tend to develop that attitude that it's good to fall ill once in a while, just to gain that attention. Of course, it happens at a very subconscious level. We may not articulate this in so many words to ourselves, but then if you look at a pattern, if you detach yourself and look at it, we realize that very often the identity of a victim is what frames the attitude towards health. And that is something that we need to start examining. What do we have an attitude? If yes, is it the identity of a victim? Or is it the identity of someone who thinks health is important for us to do other things in life? And it sounds like a very simple process, but I would think it's probably the part of the fish philosophy which takes the greatest amount of time, because very often we resist even defining our attitude towards health. What is it that we think about well-being? Once we've defined that, once we've come out of that victim identity into an identity of strength, then we can move on to applying the other parts of the philosophy where we talk of play. Now, I would prefer to apply this philosophy of play very literally as far as health is concerned. It is certainly important to be physically active in some form. Right? So be it your morning walks, be it a particular sport, an outdoor game, or be it even mental health, where you try and challenge yourself maybe with puzzles, crosswords, chess, sudoku. But that balance, that playing with our health is very important, but playing in a very positive developmental sense, right? Not taking a chance with health. So that philosophy, the discipline towards play, will come in only if we've defined that attitude which says, yes, my health is important to me, and therefore, in order to keep it alive physically and mentally, it's important to play. Give those muscles some exercise and strengthen them. How do we define making their day with respect to health?
Keeping ourselves fit, mm-hmm. and doing our, when we have done our walk,
yes,
we have made our day.
We've made our day, and because we've made our day, you're pleasant to other people around us as well, right? So the energy automatically percolates. Right? It's like that story of spreading a smile. I'm sure it's there in a lot of these children's books, where this person decides to spread a smile one day because he feels very gloomy about it, but he realizes it doesn't hurt to smile at someone. So he simply smiles at a stranger, and that stranger, of course, is also passing through his own problems and is very in a very gloomy mood, but just because a stranger smiles at him, he feels better. he decides to pass on the smile, and through the day you realize that there are hundreds of people whose lives have been brightened just because of one smile. Similarly, we decide to play, we decided to be healthy, and when we do that, we become an inspiration towards others. And definitely we can make others' day because we are healthy and we are far more willing and inspired to contribute. And that definitely makes a lot of other people's days. Imagine a day, if you look at a typical household where the mother tends to be the center of the household. If the mother is ill, the whole house tends to be gloomy because there's no one to get things done, no one to arrange things, no one to cook, right? And we've really ruined a lot of others' days. So imagine the impact that our health can have in making other people's day. And of course, being there is really fundamental in not just our personal well-being, but also in our relationships. How many times are we really there in the moment? How many of us at this moment are thinking about what to do at 5 o'clock? Great. Appreciable. Great. Very often we're seated at one place and we think of 5 hours and 5 months and 5 years hence, and that's really not being in the moment, because what is it that you're doing to respect this point in time which is creating your future? You can't be in the future and create the future, right? We have to be in the present for us to be able to create the future. And that is very seminal even as far as our health is concerned, because we have to pay attention to our health in this moment so that there is nothing else which is generated, no injury or no unhealthy issues that are generated in the future. So that is definitely one important part of the philosophy. Being there, of course, can be incorporated as a part of the health culture through exercise, through meditations, through any kind of an activity which centers ourselves. It could be as simple as listening to music or dancing, whatever appeals to you, but anything that centers us and the focus is on us as an individual, as a being. And that's where being there comes from. All this is a repeated thing, but what we really need to start with every day in the morning is choosing our attitude. Wake up in the morning and possibly open your hands like a book and decide to choose. The downward smiley, upward smiley. What is it that you decide to choose in the morning? Right? And if you decide to choose this, then that's the promise that you make to yourself on that day and say that, yes, I decide to be healthy. I decide to bring an attitude of being positive. And that's a choice I make throughout the day. And it's a repeated promise. It's a commitment that you renew every day. And that's the fish philosophy as far as personal well-being goes. Do we have questions?